So welcome back students, this is our binary mixture. This binary mixture is made up of two organic compounds. What are the possible combinations of the organic compounds present in this mixture? I have discussed this in the first video. What I do is, for my convenience, I divide the given binary organic mixture into four groups. What are the possible combinations? Can you please tell me? The possible combinations are acid plus phenol, acid plus base, acid plus neutral, or phenol base, phenol neutral, base neutral. Anything of acid, phenol, base, and neutral. And I have told you the best way to welcome any organic compound is by using these welcome drinks. What are they? This is water, sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydroxide, and HCl. In the right sequence. See, if someone comes to your place, the first thing which you offer is water. Right? So, the right sequence of welcoming the organic molecules are water, sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydroxide, and HCl. Let us see their purposes. Water for solubility, sodium bicarbonate for carboxylic acids or even sulfonic acids, but sulfonic acids are ruled out in our syllabus. Sodium hydroxide for phenols. Why? Because phenols are also known as carbolic acids. And HCl is for base. So let us welcome. The first thing which we do is, we take the organic binary mixture and we add small amount of water and we see whether the quantity of the compound by any means is decreasing or not. I don't see any decrease in the quantity, so I can say that both the organic compounds are water insoluble. Though there is one more test by which we can confirm whether the given molecule is water soluble or water insoluble. How do we do that? Keep watching the video. Next. So we are done with the solubility part. What is the next part? Carboxylic acid. Okay, so I take small amount of the mixture. So this I add sodium bicarbonate. Now if you remember the reaction, if at all there are carboxylic acids present, I will see effervescence. Yes, can you see effervescence here? I can see it. Of course, you can also see it. One thing is for sure, one of the organic compound is carboxylic acid. Yes, now you see, there are two things. Please concentrate on this. One, the liquid part, and the other, solid part. The liquid part is carboxylic acid which has reacted with sodium bicarbonate to form sodium salt of carboxylic acid. And the other part is the other organic compound. That could be phenol, base, neutral, whatever. Because this is salt and this is water soluble salt. Now I need to check whether the given carboxylic acid which we have seen is present, is it water soluble or water insoluble? Now mind you, we have already done a test which says it is water insoluble. We need to confirm. Now remember, this solid part is known as residue and the liquid part is known as filtrate. It's like you making chai. The chai is filtrate and the left out leaves are residue. So what I do is, I will now filter it. Now let me ask you a question. Can you please tell me the thing which I have collected here is it filtrate or residue? It is filtrate. Does it carry the sodium salt of acid or does it carry the other organic compound? It carries the sodium salt of acid because it is water soluble. Yes? The other part which is left out is residue. Okay? So this part which is left out is residue. Now, like I told you before, I need to confirm whether this sodium salt of acid is it water soluble or water insoluble. So what I do is, if you remember the reaction, to this I add HCl. Yes. So when I add HCl, can you see the solid coming back? Yes. What does that mean? The original carboxylic acid was water insoluble. Check it out for yourself. कैसे हुआ रिएक्शन? सोडियम सॉल्ट ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड रिएक्ट विद HCl टू गिव यू द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड प्लस NaC, राइट? सो वन थिंग इज कंफर्म्ड इन दिस मॉलिक्यूल, दैट इज इन दिस मिक्सचर रादर, इज दैट वन ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल इज वाटर इनसॉल्युबल एसिड. नाउ बिकॉज यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट वन ऑफ द कंपाउंड इज वाटर इनसॉल्युबल एसिड, आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट द अदर टाइप. सो व्हाट आई डू नाउ इज आई कलेक्ट द एंटायर मिक्सचर. I already know that one of the compounds is water insoluble acid. So I need to remove the water insoluble acid completely. Right? What is my purpose? I want to remove the carboxylic acid and work out on the other organic compound left. Right? You can see beautiful effervescence. I will add extra amount of sodium bicarbonate so that all the acids get reacted and can be removed. Right? So this filtrate part, this is the filtrate, this is residue, and this is effervescence. So if I remove it, the acid has been removed. Now the part which is left out, this is the part we are talking about. What could this part be? Acid is ruled out now. Acid is already removed. Now this part can either be phenol, it could be base, or it could be neutral. So once acid is done, what is the next sequence of organic compound? It has to be a phenol. Test for phenol. You are not sure whether it is phenol or not. So what I do is, I take small amount of the compound, I divide this into two parts. One test for phenol, the other test for base. Why don't I have any compound for neutral? Because if it is neutral, it will not react or it will not show any test for phenol or base. Let's see. So when I add sodium hydroxide to this compound, which I assume could be phenol, let me see the reaction. I can see definite color change of sodium hydroxide. Now I can also see the compound getting dissolved in sodium hydroxide. What does that mean? It means the compound could be phenolic. Yes? See, I can see the reaction. Yes. It is getting dissolved in sodium hydroxide. What does that mean? The given other organic compound is a phenol. What do I do next? I need to check whether it is water soluble or water insoluble. Now what is the possible reaction here? Phenol reacting with sodium hydroxide to give you sodium phenoxide, which is a salt. Like I told you in video 1, this is a water soluble phenol now. I mean, the salt is water soluble. I need to check whether it is water soluble phenol or not. To this I add HCl. Do you see solid? Yes. The solid regenerates. What does that mean? It is water insoluble phenol. So from this binary mixture, what have we done? There were two organic compounds. We have separated both of them. One was water insoluble acid, the other is water insoluble phenol. How did we check whether it is water insoluble acid or water soluble acid? First, it showed reaction with sodium bicarbonate. To that I added HCl, acid is regenerated, right? So it is water insoluble. Water insoluble acid present. First, the phenol reacted with sodium hydroxide and with HCl, the solid or the original phenol is regenerated. Thus, it is confirmed it is water insoluble phenol. So our given binary mixture was water insoluble acid plus water insoluble phenol. Let me quickly revise in 30 seconds. I had an organic binary mixture. Binary mixture meaning two organic compounds. Okay, it could be acid, phenol, base, neutral, any one of these combinations. You start with water, you check the solubility, sodium bicarbonate for carboxylic acids, sodium hydroxide for phenols, HCl for bases, neutral compounds do not react. Yes, after carrying out the experiment, we conclude the given organic binary mixture was water insoluble acid plus water insoluble phenol.